Good morning, students. Welcome to the online classes of 3AD Memorial Senior Secondary School. Today, we are going to start the first chapter for our first unit of English Reader Book for Class 7. So, the name of the first unit is Growing Up, and the first section is A Gift of Chuckles. We'll go through the reading portion and we'll complete the exercise also. Okay? So, let's start the reading. A smiling Rukmani threw open the door. Ravi and Meena rushed out, and Ravi pulled Mridu into the house. Wait, let me take off my slippers, protested Mridu. She set them out neatly near a pair of large black ones. Those were grey, actually, with dust. You could see the clear mark of every toe on the front part of each slipper. The marks for the two big toes were long and strong. Now, we get to know that there are a few children here. Like this is Meena, Ravi, Mridu. These are the names of the children. Okay. And Rukmani is someone who opened the door. She must be the elder one. Okay. And Ravi pulled Mridu into the house, but Mridu protested at least to take out the chappals. Okay. Take out the slippers. And there she found that another pair of slippers was there, and that was grey. Actually, that was just three slippers. Okay. And there were clear marks of every toe on the front part of each slipper. The marks of the two big toes were long and scrawny. Scrawny means very awful. Okay. Mridu didn't have much time to wonder about whose slippers they were, because Ravi dragged her to the backyard behind a thick bitterberry bush. There, inside a torn football lined with sacking and filled with sand, lay a very small kitten, lapping up milk from a coconut half shell. In the next paragraph, we get to find out why she didn't have much time to wonder. Mridu didn't have much time to wonder about the slippers because Ravi pulled her to the backside, to the backyard, okay, behind the bitterberry bush. Okay. There she saw a football filled with mud, and a kitten was there. Kitten was laying down there, lapping the milk from a coconut half shell. This is the half shell of coconut, okay, the harder one. We found him outside the gate this morning. He was mewing and mewing. Poor thing, said Meena. Meena said we found it outside the gate and he was mewing a lot. It's a secret. Amma says Pati will leave. Pati will leave for our Padu Mama's house if she knows we have a cat. She says Pati won't be here. She will go to Padu Mama's house if she come to know that we got a cat here. People are always telling us to be kind to animals, but when we are, they scream, "Oh, don't bring that dirty creature here," said Ravi. Do you know how hard it is just to get a little milk from the kitchen? Pati saw me with a glass in my hand just now. I told her I'm very hungry, I want to drink it. But the way she looked at me, I had to drink most of it to throw her off the scent. Then she wanted the tumbler back. Pati, I'll wash it myself. Why should I put you in trouble? I told her. I had to run and pour the milk into this coconut shell and then run back and wash the tumbler and put it back before she got really suspicious. Now we have to think of some other way to feed Mahindran. Here we get to know that the children are talking that people often say that don't be cruel to animals, but when we are good at them, they scream at us, "Why did you bring this creature at home?" Okay. Ravi told that it is very hard for me even to feed the kitten with a milk. He says that when he went to the kitchen, Pati, that is the mother, Pati saw him and she asked what he is doing, and he said he is hungry. He told Pati that he is hungry so that he wants to drink some milk. Pati stayed there to see whether he was going to drink or not. To show her, Ravi had to drink half of the milk, and Pati said put the tumbler back, but Ravi had to convince her that he will wash the tumbler. Why should he put Pati into trouble? And then he ran away to pour the milk in the coconut shell, and then went back to the kitchen and washed the tumbler and put back. And in the last line, we get to know that the name of the cat is Mahindran. Now, Mahindran, this little kitty's name is Mahindran. Mridu was impressed. It was a real name, not just a cute kitty cat name. Now Mridu was impressed with the name given to the cat, that is Mahindran. Actually, his full name is Mahindra Varma Pallava Punahi, MP Punahi for short, if you like. He's a fine breed of cat. Just look at his fur, like a lion's mane. And you know what the emblem of the ancient Pallav kings was, don't you? He looked expectantly at Mridu. Mridu giggled. Now, Ravi tells that the actual name, full name is Mahendra Varma Pallava Punai. And for short one, you can call her MP Punai. And he says that he is a fine fur cat. You can see this. And don't you know the emblem of Pallava kings, ancient Pallava kings? Don't you? Now, he expected that Mridu would know. But Mridu giggled, laughed. Think I'm joking? Well, just wait. I'll show you sometime. Now, he says, I'll tell you. Okay. It's clear you don't know anything about the history. Haven't been to Mahabalipuram? Have you? He said mysteriously. Well, when our class went to Mahabalipuram, I saw a statue of Tathas, etc., etc., etc. Fact is, Mahendran here has descended from that very same ancient cat, a close relative, scientifically speaking, of none other than the lion, the Pallava lion, emblem of the Pallava dynasty. Ravi went on walking around the bitterberry bush, weaving a twig up and down, his eyes sparkling. This cat is a descendant of none other than the Mahabalipuram Rishi cat. And if I may just remind you, they worshipped cats in ancient Egypt. Now here Ravi starts telling about the ancient thing about the cat and tells that the cat is a descendant of lion, the Pallava lion, okay, the emblem of Pallava kings. And says that even in Egypt, cats were worshipped. So, well, one of the descendants of that cat goddess was a stowaway in one of the Pallava ships, and his descendant was the Mahabalipuram Rishi cat, whose descendant is Ravi flourished his twig at Mahendran MP Punai here. He shrieked while pleased with himself. Now he started telling something more about the Egyptian goddess of cat and how the cat descended here. Now, Mahendran looked up alarmed. He had just been sharpening his claws on the edge of the coconut shell, but worse than Ravi's awful whoop was a screech from the window. What a weird sound. If Mridu was startled, MP Punai was frightened out of his wits. Hair standing on the head and on end, he bounced up and scurried towards a bamboo tray of red chilies that had been set out to dry. Trying to hide beneath it, he tipped a few chilies over himself.
Meow!
He howled miserably. Okay. Now Mahendran looked up alarmed. Mahendran was alarmed. For what? He had just been sharpening his claws. Claws are the nails of a cat. Okay. On the edge of coconut shell. Rubbing on the edge of coconut shell. But worse than Ravi's awful whoop was the screech. Screech from the window. Okay. Some noise from the window. And that was a weird one. Mridu was startled. She was shaken. MP Punai was frightened. So he tried to hide he tried to bounce towards a bamboo tray of red chilies that had been set out to dry. Trying to hide beneath it, he tipped a few chilies over himself. That is, a few chilies fell on him. Okay, and he made the noise. The screeching went on and on. What's that noise? Said Mridu. What the noise is? Mridu asked. That's Lali is learning to play the violin. Granted, Ravi. She'll never learn a thing. Now Ravi was grunting in anger. That's Lali learning to play the violin, and I know she won't be learning it anyhow. Mridu crept up to the window. Lali was sitting a little distance away, awkwardly holding her violin and bowstring. Her elbows jutting out and her eyes glazed with concentration. In front of her, with most of his back to the window, was the bony figure of the music master. He had an almost bald head with a fringe of oily black hair fading around his ears and an old-fashioned tuft. A gold chain gleamed around his leathery neck and a diamond ring glittered on his hand as it glided up and down the stem of the violin. Large foot struck out from beneath his gold-bordered vashti edge and he was waiting some meeting time on the floor with the scrawny big top. Now we get to know about the teacher and the learner. Okay, Mridu looked through the window. Lali was sitting a distance away from her master, and master was an old man with half bald head, okay, oil hairs. The remaining hairs were the oil one. He was wearing a gold chain around the neck and a diamond ring or two. Okay, so here in this paragraph, master is described. The violin master is described. He played a few notes. Lali stumbled behind him on her violin, which looked quite helpless and unhappy in her hands. What a difference! The music master's notes seemed to float up and settle perfectly into the invisible tracks of the melody. It was like the wheels of a train fitting smoothly into the rails and whizzing along, as Ravi said. Vidhu stared at that huge hand moving effortlessly up the violin string, making lovely music. Now they both were overjoyed with the way the master was playing the violin. Okay, square! There was Lali's jingling again, and then Lali again started playing violin. Amma! Came a wail from the gate. Amma! Oh! Ravi sent that beggar away, cried his mother from the back veranda where she was chatting with Tapi. He has been coming here every day for the past week, and it's time he found another house to beg from. Pati explained to Tapi. Now there was a noise at the gate. Amma! And now mother cries that from the back veranda, Ravi sent the beggar away. Okay. He has been coming here every day, and finally he found another house to beg on. So ask him to leave the house. Mridu and Meena followed Ravi out. The beggar was already in the garden, making himself quite home. Go away, said Ravi sternly. My Pati says it's time for you to find another house to beg from. He says, leave now. Beggar opened his eyes very wide and gazed at each of the children one by one. He then raised his voice. Amma, Amma, oh! Said his wail might be, but it certainly wasn't feeble. Okay. He raised his voice. Amma, Amma, oh! Ravi tells him that there's nothing left in the kitchen, called Rukmani, and he's not to come again. Tell him that. Now Rukmani says, Ravi, ask him, tell him that there's nothing left in the kitchen, just leave on and don't come back again. She was fed up actually. Ravi didn't have to repeat it all to the beggar because his mother's voice was very easy to listen for everybody there. The beggar sat up and sighed. Now beggar says, I'll go. Only let me have some rest here under the tree. The sun is so hot. The coal tar has melted on the roads. My feet are already blistered. I'm unable to walk. I don't have any slippers. I'm barefoot. He stretched out his feet to show large feet, peeling blisters on the soles of his bare feet. Okay. I suppose he doesn't have the money to buy chappals, Mridu whispered to Meena and Ravi. Have you got an old pair of slippers for him? I don't know, said Ravi. Mine are too small to fit his feet. I would have given them to him. His feet were larger than Mridu's and Meena's shoe. So he needs something big. Okay. Meena said, her big eyes falling. It's not fair that he's not having slippers and we can't even help. Shh! Quiet, said Ravi. I'm thinking about it, blubbering. It's not fair. It's going to hell. Isn't going to hell. In 2 minutes, he'll be flying his feet on that road. Now they think that it's time to help him anyhow. What he needs is a pair of chappals. So where do we get them? Come, let's search the house. He pushed Mridu and Meena into the house to search for the chappal for the bag. Just as she stepped into the veranda, Mridu's eyes fell on the odd looking chappals she had noticed when she ran. Ravi! Whose are these? Ravi turned and glanced at the shabby looking but sturdy old slippers. He beamed and nodded. These are just the right size, he said, picking them up. Now he was happy to find out the old chappals. Mridu and Meena followed him nervously back into the garden as they had picked up the old and shabby chappals. Here, said Ravi to the beggar, dropping the slippers in front of the man, old man. Wear these and don't come back. The beggar stared at the slippers hurriedly, flung his towel over the shoulder, pushed his feet into them and left muttering a blessing to the children. Okay, he blessed children for providing the slippers. In a minute, he had vanished around the corner of the street. Now he ran away. Basically, he started moving fast. The music master came out of the house and took an unappreciative look at the three of them sitting quietly under the tree playing marbles. He was not happy that the three were playing under the tree. Then he searched for his chappals in the veranda where he had put them. Lali, he called. After a few moments, she hurried up to him. Have you seen my chappals, my dear? I remember having kept them here. Ravi, Mridu and Meena silently watched Lali and the music master search every corner of veranda. He stared around, looking over railing and crouching near the flower pots to look between them. Brand new they were. I went all the way to Mount Road to buy them. He went on saying they cost a whole month's fee. Now they started searching the chappal all over the house, and master says they were the brand new. And the cost of the chappals is the whole month's fee. Soon Lali went to tell her mother. Rukmani appeared looking harassed with Pati following her. Now Lali went on to tell everything about the happening to her mother, and Rukmani appeared and she was harassed. Okay. Where could they be? It's really quite upsetting to think someone might have stolen them. So many vendors come to the door. Where Pati? Pati says, maybe someone has stolen it. So much vendors come here. Rukmani caught sight of Ravi, Mridu and Meena sitting under the tree. Have you children? She began, and then seeing they were curiously quiet, went on more slowly. Seen anyone lurking around the veranda? A sharp V-shaped line had formed between her eyebrows. Another straight, tighter one appeared in place of her usually soft, pleasant mouth. Rukmani was angry, thought Mridu with a shiver. She wouldn't be so upset if she knew about the poor beggar with sores on his feet, she tried to tell herself. Now Rukmani caught all the three children and asked them what happened actually, and she was very angry. Rukmani was in anger mode. Okay. And now Mridu was shivering because Rukmani was angry. She thought, if I tell her about the beggar and the sore feet he had, maybe she will become soft again. Taking a deep breath, she cried, Rukmani, there was a beggar here. Poor thing, he had such boils on his feet. So Rukmani said Rukmani grimly, turning to Ravi, you gave the music master's chappals to that old beggar who turns up here? Now she asked, did you give them? Children these days, groaned Pati. Amma, didn't you tell me about Karan who gave away everything he had, even his gold earrings? He was so kind and generous. Silly, snapped Rukmani. Karan didn't give away other people's things, he only gave away his own. But my chappals wouldn't have fitted the beggar's feet, Ravi rushed brashly on. And Amma, if they did fit, would you really not have minded? Now Ravi says that, Amma, but the thing is, you told me that Karan also gave everything what he had to anyone who demanded for everything. And Amma said that Karan gave the things that he owned, not the others. Now Ravi said that it was impossible for me to give mine because they would not have fitted. And if they would have fitted, would you have it minded? Ravi, said Rukmani, very angry now. Now Rukmani was very much angry. She hurried indoors and brought out Gopu Mama's hardly worn new chappals. This should fit you, sir. Please put these on. I'm so sorry. My son has been very naughty. The music master's eyes lit up. He put them on, trying not to look too happy. Well, I suppose these will have to do. These days, children have no respect for elders. What to do? Rukumani's eyes flashed. She stood stiff and straight by the front door. It was clear she wanted him to leave quickly. Now, Rukmani hurried and brought the new chappals of Gopu Mama that he hardly wore, okay, and said, these may fit you, sir, okay. And now music master took those slippers and was very happy because they were the new one, and trying not to show that he was very happy, he said, I suppose these may do, and says, these days children, they don't know how to respect elders. Listening this, Rukmani was more angry and she wanted the music master to leave as soon as possible. When he had lighted off in his new chappals, she said, Mridu, come in and have some tiffin. Honestly, how do you children think of such things? Thank God your Gopu Mama doesn't wear his chappals to work. As she walked towards the kitchen with Mridu and Meena, she suddenly began to laugh. But he's always in such a hurry to throw off his shoes and socks and get into his chappals as soon as he comes home. What's your mama going to say this evening when I tell him I gave his chappals to the music master? Rukumani says that honestly, don't you think what you have done, you should have thought twice at least. Come and get tiffin. Now she starts laughing that what would your Gopu mama will think? Thank God he don't wear chappal at work. But he is used to come back to take off the shoes and rightly wear the slippers. But what will he think that where the slippers had gone when he returns home this evening? So that's the chapter, students. Moving on to the question answers. What caught Mridu's attention at the door? Why? The slippers outside the house caught the attention of Mridu as they were full of dust and looked very old. What reason did Ravi give for naming the cat Mahendra Varma Pallava Kunai? Ravi said that the cat is a descendant of Pallava Kunai, the emblem of the Pallava dynasty. Describe the music master and his music session but in a style of your own. The music master was a fat person with partially bald head and oiled hairs near his ears. He wore a gold chain round the neck. What thought made Mridu tell herself that Rukumani would not be angry about the disappearance of the chappals? Mridu thought that mother won't be angry if she tells her that she helped the beggar by providing the old slippers to him. Now think and answer, why didn't Mridu have time to wonder about whose slippers they were? Mridu didn't have time to wonder about whose slippers they were because Ravi dragged her to the backyard behind a thick bitter berry bush. What prompted the children to give the chappals to the beggar? Large pink peeling blisters on the soles of the beggar's bare feet prompted the children to give the chappals to the beggar. Don't you think there is something interesting about the pair of chappals in the story? What is it? The interesting thing about the pair of chappals in the story is that we'll discuss it the next time. Who was the actual loser in the story? The music master or Golu Mama? The actual loser in the story was Gopu Mama, as his hardly worn new chappals were given to the music teacher in place of unattractive and lean slippers. Gopu Mama was destined to stay barefooted. I would love to ask you students to try this question yourself. I'll send you the answer. Okay. Someone's gain is another's loss. Comment in the light of the story. Yes, it's a true saying that someone's gain is another's loss. In this story, the beggar who was barefooted old slippers got old slippers. The music teacher got the new slippers in place of old and shabby one. Whereas Gopu Mama, who wanted new chappals, remained barefooted at the end. Reference: that was the whole month's fees. Who said this and to whom? Music teacher said this to Rukumani. What is there? The slippers of the music teacher. Why did the speaker say this? Because his slippers were stolen from outside the house. What happens next? Rukumani gives the new chappals to Gopu Mama to him. Okay. Students, I hope you liked the chapter, you understood the chapter in a better manner. I hope you will click on the like button, subscribe to our channel, share the video, and for more videos, upcoming videos, please click on the notification icon also. Okay, notification bell. And we'll meet you in the next video. Till then, take care. Have a nice day. Thank you.